See, what I like about that type of praise, hallelujah, hallelujah, that praise is not relegated to a particular time. In other words, go through it the only time that you need to call on Jesus. You don't have to call on him when everything is just bad, but when everything is good. I don't hear nobody talking to me. I know somebody got a wing order on the order right now, hallelujah. And I hope that the wing is good enough when you taste it this evening, that you call on the name of Jesus. Anybody that cook like that, hallelujah, that when you put the fork to your mouth, all you can say, Jesus. Real praisers know how to turn up by calling on Jesus. Because real praisers know it's not what you're going through, it's who you're going to. Watch this. They cried out, Son of David, have mercy on us. They made, watch this, a decision now. Somebody say decision. They made a decision, watch this, to believe him. They called him the Son of David. And this wasn't just any term, but the term associated with the belief that the Messiah was to be out of the lineage of King David. So to call him such meant that they believed and confessed who he really was by faith. And without having, watch this, whew, talk to me somebody, without having seen a miracle, without having received a thing, without hearing him say a word, they knew that he was the Messiah. They believed that he was the Redeemer. They believed that he was a healer. They believed that he was a deliverer. They believed who he was before they could see who he was. It amazes me what blind people can see and sinners can see from far off that church folk can't see close up. He is a healer. They made a decision to ask him to have mercy on them. Now, what they were doing sitting by the roadside was asking for alms, but they didn't ask Jesus for money. They didn't ask Jesus for money. They were sitting there to ask Jesus or to ask people for money. But when Jesus came, the thought of getting money from somebody went out the window. Because I realized this person got something that nobody else can give me. I don't need money when I got the Messiah. I don't hear nobody talking to me. How many people know that money can't buy you, watch this, the mercy that you need, amen. Woo! He said, have mercy on us. Yes. Hallelujah. In other words, I thought I knew what I wanted until I met you.
All right.
Let me offer that to some of the husbands for free. Valentine's Day is coming up. Darling, I thought I knew what I want until I met you. That's for free. If you want to send an offering, I'll give you my address later. Y'all silly. Y'all in church. Come on now. There was dilemma. Say dilemma. There was dedication. Say dedication. There was decision. Say decision. Lastly, there was determination. They cried out to Jesus.
Yeah.
Let's look at the text. Let's look and see what the text says, because I really want you to get this, hallelujah, this determination. Watch this. 29 says, as they were leaving Jericho, a large crowd followed him, and two blind men sitting by the road, hearing that Jesus was passing by, crying out, Lord, have mercy on us, son of David. Watch 31, it says, the crowd sternly told them to be quiet.
Yeah.
What does the text say? B portion. But they cried out all the more,
yeah.
Lord, son of David, have mercy on us.
Yeah.
Woo, I'm looking for, listen, at my church I call them like this. I'm raising, pastor, right now, I'm raising a crop of what I call ignorant praisers. In other words, these are the type of praisers that don't care what you have to say, don't care what you think, don't care how you look, because truth be told, they get attitude with it and shake their head like black folk do when they mean something. You were not there. Can I go to the old song? Hallelujah. You were not there when I needed you. Hallelujah. It was in your name that I can call on, but in the middle of the night when I needed a prayer to get to heaven, it was Jesus that heard my prayer. It was Jesus that delivered me. It was Jesus that comforted me. It was Jesus that made a way. It was Jesus that healed me. It was Jesus that provided. It was Jesus that delivered. Watch this. And so I came to church simply because of this. I owe him a praise. All your bills, hallelujah. But can I get somebody that know you passed due on what you owe Jesus? Hallelujah, because you owe him so much praise. You can't praise him enough for everything. Oh, come on, let's go scripture. If I had 10,000 tongues, I could not praise him enough. Somebody in here on the sound of my voice got the type of praise that if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I don't know where I could be, where I would be. I'm talking to somebody in here that knows you was a trip in the 90s. I'm talking to somebody in here that knows you could have been taken out in the 80s. I'm talking to somebody here had more swag with their bell bottoms in the 70s than a wall out. I'm talking to my Motown people. Come on, talk to me. Talking to some of y'all looking for me, so I'm gonna come for you. Some of y'all that used to Wayne Dang and Doodle. Oh, Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. How many people know that if it had not been for the Lord, I wouldn't be in this church today? If it had not been for the Lord, I wouldn't be able to lift my hands. Day by day, glory by glory, new mercies I see.
Thank you.
Quiet. Don't bother Jesus. You see all these folk around Jesus? Can I make it plain? You see all these folk around Jesus? You know, I've been standing in line for a long time. Y'all know how y'all get when y'all be in line.
Yeah.
Even somebody look like they're approaching the cut, you looking at them funny. Yeah. I don't know what she thinks to you. Watch this. You talk to other people or to yourself, but you say it loud enough.
Yeah.
I don't know where she thinks she going. Standing in this line so long. Come on, y'all know how to be in Walmart.
Yeah. Alright.
25 cash registers, two people taking items, hallelujah. You standing in line for so long. Look, the people are like, listen, we've been rolling with him for a little while now.
Well, yeah.
And you expect him to start doing what he's doing for you?
Right.
Close your mouth. Well, chill out, Mr. Blind Man.
Yeah.
Stay right there. Wait your turn. If you want to get up and follow us, we'll find somebody to lead you as we follow him.
Yeah.
But you got to wait your turn.
All right, now.
I came to talk to just 50 folk that was shouting right here. That it might not be your turn, but it is your time. Y'all ain't ready to shout. Y'all ain't ready to get what God got for you. Hallelujah. Everybody else has been waiting. Everybody else has been more qualified. But God has said, I'm going to look past everybody else and hear you simply because you, the way you cried and called upon me. Do I have anybody in here that has a power in your voice that determination to keep crying out and reach him with their voice. I got a word for you today. It's simply this. Don't stop crying out to the Lord. He's the only one that can answer your prayers. But I got one instruction for you. Holler until he hears you. See, I'm getting mad with y'all right now. Because I see a lot of jerseys on, hallelujah, from high school to professional. And some of y'all holler loud at the game. They're hollering right now. I got to go. It was dilemma, it was dedication, it was decision, it was dedication. Lastly, there was deliverance. Let's look back at the text. Verse 32 says, and Jesus stopped and called them. That's y'all material, Pastor. I want to help somebody. You've been calling him so long. He's about to flip the script. You no longer have to call him because he's calling you. No, watch this. No matter what other people are saying, he's calling
you.
No matter who's been waiting, he's calling
you.
Oh, my God, today. No matter how long you've been dealing with it, now is your time because he's calling. He stopped. He was teaching. He was marching.
Yeah.
He was on his way to Jericho. He was on his way to Jerusalem. He was coming from Jericho. Let me insert this real quick and I'm going to get out your way. Hallelujah. He was coming from Jericho on his way to Jerusalem. Now I want you to think about what that means real quick in the spiritual. Jericho, we know the story of Jericho. Jericho, they marched around the wall 7 times, let out a great. Come on, class. They marched around the walls 7 times, let out a great. Now you know I'm a teacher because I get you to interact with me. Hallelujah. And they marched around the wall 7 times. And then on the 7th time, they let out a great. And the walls came tumbling. Ooh, y'all good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. They marched around the walls and the walls came tumbling down. So Jericho represents a falling down.
Yeah.
He was on his way to Jerusalem.
Yeah.
Jerusalem, hallelujah, was where he was going to be crucified, hallelujah, buried. But watch this, on the 3rd day, he was going to do what?
Rise.
See, y'all said rise up. I hear you, fellas, hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's the only one I'm going to give you. Hallelujah. On the 3rd day, he rose, hallelujah. He rose again, hallelujah. So Jericho meant a breaking down.
Yes, sir.
Jerusalem, I give it to you again, meant a rising up.
Amen.
Can I tell you something? In between Jericho and Jerusalem is where he meets these 2 blind men.
Yeah.
So in between your breaking down and your rising up, your blessing is on the way. Yeah. He stopped, watch this, and said, what do you want me to do for you?
Yeah.
I wish that y'all would act like Jesus is asking you that question right now.
Yeah.
What do you want me to do for you?
Yeah.
He stopped and said, listen, watch this. I know what your predicament is.
Yeah.
But your predicament might not equal your request.
Well.
But what do you want me to do for you? In other words, watch this. I know what your predicament is, but do you trust me enough to verbalize what it is that you feel you really need? Do you trust me enough to ask me what it is that you really want? Hallelujah. He said, what do you want me to do for you? They said, listen, we want you, hallelujah, we want you to give us our sight back. We want you, as a matter of fact, watch this. They said this, we want you to give us our sight. We want you to give us, watch this, our sight.
Well,
we want you to give us our sight. What do you want me to do for you? We want you to give us our sight. So Jesus responded, I got to go to the level of their faith.
Amen.
Now, watch this. They're asking Jesus to do something that the Bible never records that he's done before.
Well,
they're asking that has never been recorded. Watch this. All they had was the Old Testament. The Bible in the Old Testament never records a blind person being healed from their blindness. So in other words, this measures their faith. We want you to do something that we never read has been done. We want to do something that we never heard had been done in church. We want you to do something for us that nobody we know has attested to it happening. Can you work this work, watch this, that only you can? I wish I had somebody. I know you got some family members that look like they'll never be saved. But you know that God has all the power through his son Jesus, and the Holy Spirit can go and arrest them right now. And by the time you get home, you got a phone call saying Ray Ray and Pookie and them went to church. Ray Ray and Pookie and them was on the office altar. Hallelujah. Ray Ray, Keisha and all them, they got saved. Can I have anybody in here that knows that God has the power to turn it all around? Somebody says, and I'm gone. I thank you, Pastor Brighthawk, for inviting me back. I don't want to stay too long because I want to be able to come back. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Listen, verse 20, 32 says, what do you want me to do for you? They said to him, Lord, we want our eyes open. Verse 34 is my last verse. Moved with compassion.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Moved. That's shout.
Yeah.
Moved with compassion.
Yes. Yeah.
My pastor used to sing this song all the time. Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise.
Yes.
For it was grace that wrought my liberty. I do not know just why he came to love me so. This is the shouting part, but he looked beyond. Somebody else shout right there. All of my faults. And saw my knees. Why? Because he's moved with compassion. Do you realize that the Lord loves you so much that he can look beyond everything that you've done? He loves you so much that the measure of what you're dealing with has no merit to him. He loves you so much that he'll take time out of everything that he's doing just to bless you. He loves that everybody that's tied to you, hallelujah, when he blesses you, he's going to bless them. Can you grab somebody's hand? Shake it like you're going to shake it off. Come on, say he's getting ready to bless the both of us. We're both getting ready to get it back. We lost it at one time. Hallelujah. But he's here right now. He's getting ready to restore. He's getting ready to rejuvenate. He's getting ready to revive. He's getting ready to heal. Their eyes. Woo, I have to go. Y'all pushing me. And immediately, somebody shout out immediately. Shout out immediately. Give three people high five and say immediately. 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 That means shout because it's on the way. It ain't going to take them long to do it. I know you've been asking a long time, but I serve a suddenly God. Talking to me, you can go from ashy to classy to one touch. You can go from broke to rich from one touch. You can go from hurt to healed one touch. Immediately, they regained their sight. Watch this, discipleship. And they followed him. How many people have decided that you will follow Jesus? How many people, come on, stand up all over here, but how many people have decided that they're going to follow Jesus? No turning back. No turning back. I just wanted to encourage you today. Whatever it is that you've been seeking him for, whatever it is you thought you lost, I got news for you, my brother. I got news for you, my sister. You're getting ready to get it back. Yeah.